It's week 7, lucky number 7. Don't look now, but Andy Dalton is the number one FanDuel quarterback right now. Week 4 of the NFL season, and that means the bye weeks are here, which also means that we need to get creative. Here's a lineup that I put together for this week.
Can we trust Eddie Lacy or James Starks this week?
I don't know if we can trust them, but we can definitely take a risk on them, which I think is a decent idea. Yeah. No one respects Green Bay right now. Everyone is saying stay away from the Green Bay Packers, so you might be one of a very small handful of people that decide to put one of these guys out there. Me personally, I would go with Eddie Lacy. Seattle's defense is nasty, unless they're defending the tight end. In fact, the Seahawks have allowed the second most FanDuel points to opposing tight ends, allowing a league-high average of 78.4 receiving yards per game.
Yeah, Brandon, I'm curious, do you think in our lifetimes we're going to see a female head coach in the NFL or no?
Yeah, especially now that we're going next-gen stats, I think that the way that everything is moving, yeah, this is all an analytical thing. You know, I'm someone who works in fantasy football. Again, totally gender-neutral. It's spreadsheets. Mm-hmm. You know, you don't need to be a man or to have ever played to have done that. Now, obviously, players have a certain mentality that is important to the game, and that will never go away. But when it comes to actual scheming, that's, you know, I think that's going to be up for debate pretty soon here.
He is the undisputed number two guy with Aaron Rodgers throwing the ball. Now, Jay Cutler, as divisive as he may be, still does like to sling the ball around. So do check on those Alshon Jeffrey injury news and see what's going on with Eddie Royal. He had a great rookie season with Jay Cutler. They're reunited, and maybe it feels so good. I don't know. We'll see. I like to do what I call drafting backwards. That means that I start with my defense, then my kicker, and then my tight end, and then I kind of mix and match with the skill players. Putting together a lineup during wildcard weekend is as fun as it is challenging. Getting creative and balancing out risks are at an all-time high. Here is a startup lineup that you can plug in, switch out, and play for the win.
Do you think Brady is going to be highly owned against a tough Buffalo D?
Well, he is kind of becoming this popular contrarian pick, if that makes any sense to you. But here's the deal. Pittsburgh Steelers left Rob Gronkowski just wide open. Michael Floyd has back-to-back 100-yard outings. And also, this might be surprising, he scored 13 or more FanDuel points in all but one of his last 7 games. This is a great matchup. The Philadelphia Eagles give up the second most passing touchdowns in the league. Finally, the Jacksonville Jaguars gave TJ Yeldon the goal line work. And they did it twice, back to back. For that reason, I'm risking it again, and I'm plugging Yeldon into my lineup. The Colts give up the 10th most FanDuel points to opposing running backs, so hopefully Yeldon and the coaching staff can make the most out of this cushy matchup. And no lineup is complete without a super stud wide receiver. So I'm anchoring my lineup with Odell Beckham Jr. It's tough because it's either AJ McCarron or Brian Hoyer with 2 concussions in a month, so a little dicey. Hopefully one of these guys will give you some extra cap space this week while you set your winning roster. Yeah, it's interesting because Doug Martin's doing so well, you're not realizing that Charles Sims is sneakily almost averaging 10 FanDuel points per game. The Atlanta Falcons, they give up almost 74 yards receiving to running backs every single week. If you roster just one of these guys, you should come out on top. If you roster more than one bargain, you can spend the big money on the stars you need. I'm looking at you, Hopkins and Beckham. For FanDuel Insider, I'm Brandon Marianne Lee. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm Brandon Marianne Lee, and good luck in week 1.